Mango, an elementary school classroom in a slum by Stephen Spender. The theme of the poem is the plight of poor children living in slums. He talks about social injustice and inequality. The poet wants the life of the slum children to be changed. He wants their poverty to end. He wishes them to live in healthier, hygienic and beautiful environment. Let's look at the stanza-wise summary. Stanza 1. The poet says that the condition of the children in the slum is pathetic. Their world is far removed from the urban, healthy environment. They are as unwanted as the rootless weeds. Their hair is unkempt and they have pale faces which clearly indicate their deprived and undernourished condition. These children, as a tall girl, are stressed by the burden of their circumstances. They are exhausted, both physically as well as emotionally. The paper-thin boy is skinny. His eyes have a scared look. These unfortunate beings have inherited only disease and bad luck from their parents. One of the deceased ones can't even get up from the desk to recite his lesson. However, there is one child at the back of the class who is younger than the others. His inexperienced eyes are full of hope and he is dreaming about playing games in the open. Apparently, gloom has still not enveloped him. Stanza 2. The classroom walls have a dirty appearance as they haven't been painted for a long time. In other words, these children inhabit a world which is dreary and depressing. On the walls are displayed the names of people who have given donations. The bust of Shakespeare with the background of a clear sky at the time of sunrise is also displayed. The walls also have scenic pictures of Tyrolese Valley with its beautiful flowers presenting a world of the heavenly splendor. Apart from all these, the walls also have a map revealing the world outside. Their view from the classroom's window is foggy and harsh. It represents a dark and bleak future with no hope for a better life. Their eyes can view only a narrow road which is enclosed with a dull sky. The poet suggests that these children are trapped in a hopeless situation and their reality is far removed from the literary world which glistens with the beauty of nature, such as the rivers and the high land jutting from the sea. Stanza 3. The pensive poet suddenly turns aggressive and feels that Shakespeare is wicked. This is because he misleads the children. He shows them a beautiful world full of ships, sun and love, which not only is unreal for them, but has a corrupting influence on these children and instigate them to steal and try to escape from their cramped holes. Their existence is indeed very sad. These emaciated children are so thin that it appears that they are wearing skins. The spectacles they are wearing have glass, which have been broken and mended. The entire appearance reeks of their deprivation. The poet shows his outrage by suggesting that the maps on their walls should show huge slums instead of beautiful scenic graphics. Stanza 4. In a pacifying tone, the poet appeals to the governor, inspector, and visitor to do something to improve their condition. If there is political will, this map showing the beautiful world outside can become their reality too. The poet hopes the authorities would realize their moral responsibilities and free these children from their grave-like entrapments. He wants all the barriers to be pulled down, barriers that keep away the true education from them. The children must be given freedom to experience the wholesome bounties of nature, view the green fields and run on gold sand. Let them read books and let them breathe in fresh air. Let them discover themselves and let them be creative so that their names can also enter the books of history. Let them find place under the sun. poetic devices used in the poem. Far, far is either repetition or alliteration. Gusty waves, personification. Like rootless weeds, simile. The paper seeming boy, metaphor. With rat's eye, metaphor. Surely Shakespeare, alliteration. From fog to endless night, alliteration. Like bottle bits of stone, simile. As big as doom, simile. This map becomes their window and these windows, repetition. Their lives like catacombs, simile. Break, oh break, repetition. Language is the sun, metaphor. Their tongues run naked, personification.